Hello, my name is Rickard, and in this tutorial, I'm going to give you some quick tips for matching colors in Photoshop. If you'd like to follow along, I have included a link in the description of this video of the two images that I use in this tutorial. So go ahead, download those, and then let's dive into Photoshop. I'm going to go ahead and open this Ryan Ansel file. And first thing I want to do is just convert this to a smart object. And then I'm going to go to the crop tool and just open up the crop here so that I can accommodate a second photo. All right, and then we're going to go place, linked, and let's grab this second file, the Jerry file. And we're just going to transform this so that it's as big here and then just slide it to the right. So here we go. I have both files in here. And what I want to do is I want to match this in color to this. So let's see what methods we have for doing that. We could go to adjustments, and our instinct might be to go to match color. Now, match color does not work on a smart object, but let's go ahead and make a copy of this and rasterize the layer. And I'm going to change the name of this to match color just so that we have a good A-B comparison at the end. I'm going to go to adjustments, match color. Now, normally when you match color, you're doing it to a different file. But in this case, I'm selecting the same file and I'm going to use the color from layer 0. You can see right away that that's done actually a pretty good job of getting our color closer to the color on the left. But personally, I think we could do a better job. So let's look at this. And first, let's just see how I would do it manually. So my preferred method for any kind of color correction is the curve. So I'm going to do Command M, and that's going to bring up my curve. So here's my curve. And let's go ahead and slide this a little bit more to the left so we can see both images. First thing I can see right away is that our darks are darker in this image. So I'm just going to take my black point, kind of get it to where the black point of the image is here. Next thing is my darks in here are darker than in here. So I'm just going to take the bottom of my curve and pull it down a bit. Next, this image is a lot more blue than this image. So I need to bring up the green color in here. So I could go to my green and raise it, but that's going to brighten my colors when in reality, I want to darken my colors. So in order to darken it, I have to add yellow and I have to add cyan. Now we're already pretty strong on cyan. So if I go to my reds, the opposite of red being cyan, I could adjust a little bit here, but I think honestly that our cyan level is already pretty good. I don't think I need to adjust this much. If anything, in the warmer areas here, or sorry, the highlight areas here, we seem to have a little bit more red in the left image than we do in this one, where our highlights are a little more cyan. So let's clamp the very top, and I'm just going to push that a little bit more toward red. Next, we're going to go to our blues, and I'm going to pull that down. And that's going to do a lot of the heavy lifting to get these two images looking similar. You can see, however, that we're getting a little bit too much yellow. So let's pull that back a little bit, and then maybe we'll counteract it by just adding a little bit more green here in our highlights. And then let's take a look at our reds. I'm just pulling the reds back out of the shadow areas just so we get our shadow areas a little bit closer to the one on the left there. I think something like this. So in terms of matching visually the kind of color grade of both of these images, I think that's pretty good. So let's do a comparison. You can see that the color match did something similar, but it didn't do it quite as strong, and it didn't give quite as good as an outcome as my curve here. Now, obviously, I've been doing color for many, many years and also been practicing doing curves for many years. So, I wanted to show you a quick trick on how you can get some practice to match color between two images. So, let's go ahead and throw away this curves layer. And I'm going to add blur and average. And because it's a smart object, it's going to contain the effect just to this. And what it's done is it's averaged all the colors in this image to one common color. We're going to do the same to our other smart object. And now we have a good comparison of just the color tone on top of the image. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a curves layer. And when you add a curves layer, it automatically selects the mask. So we're going to have to click here and make sure we have our color selected, not the mask. And you're going to see why we need that in a second. The next thing I want to do is double click on my neutral eyedropper here. So we're going to double click on that. And that's going to bring up this color picker. And what I want to do is I want to select this color. And basically, I'm telling Photoshop that this is the color of my neutral gray. So now I'm going to hit OK. And now, if I take this same eyedropper and click in this blue area, it's going to color correct it so that this has the same tone as that. Now I want to constrain this to just the right side here. You can see that that has now corrected the color. If I turn the eyeball on and off, you can see it's corrected my color cast and it's separated the RGB curves here to make those distinctions in the color. Now you can see that it's quite a bit lighter. So the next thing I want to do is I want to fix that lightness. Now I could drag this down a little bit here and then just drag the middle of my curve down until I get a better color match. And it looks like right about there is a good color match. Although now I see that this side has just a tiny bit more yellow. Now, this is very subtle, so it may not even translate, but this has just a tiny bit more yellow visually than this does. So I'm going to go to my blue because blue and yellow are opposites. If I pull down this just a little bit, it's going to give me a little bit more yellow in there. And we're going to get a nice good match here between these two. Now I'm going to collapse the properties. And then if we turn off our average effect here, you can now see what this color correction is doing. And it's doing a pretty good job. Now it's doing it kind of weakly, meaning not very strong. So what I can do here is I can just hold down Option and make a second copy of this curve. And it's just gonna double the effect. And with two of them, I think we get a good color match between these two images. You can see we did that without really having any visual reference aside from our average gray. And just using curves and the separated curves to match two grays is a great way to practice your understanding of which color channels to use to achieve what color. So here you can see the match color, and here you can see our curve effect. You can see again, our match color did a good job, but it just didn't do it strong enough. You can see our curve here did a really good job of matching those two colors. And that's a great little trick there if you want to match two colors. And it's also great if you're doing a composite. So in this scenario, if I take my object selection tool, go around our character here, and add a mask, and take this guy and put him in this. You can see here now with our curves and without, with those curves, he now feels like he belongs in this environment. And that's a very important thing when you're doing composites, is you want to be able to get two objects that don't look like they belong together using color to make those two objects look like they belong together. So there you have it. Those are some tips and tricks for matching colors in Photoshop. which hopefully you can incorporate into your own workflows. Now, if you enjoyed this tutorial, please leave a like, leave a comment, share this video, turn on notifications, subscribe to my channel, and if you have other methods that you use for matching colors that you think are better, go ahead, put them in the comments and let's discuss it. If you want to check out some other tutorials, you can check them out here. And if you want to check out some professional Photoshop training and tools, go to Nucly.com. All right, I will see you next time.